I'm still not super sure that that was the right choice to make. I have already been there. We'll see. We'll see. Oh. The music is so beautiful in this game, I just kind of want to wander around and enjoy it. Oh. Okay, that's an invisible wall. That is... that's an invisible wall. They could have put it something in the game to, like, explain that. You know? Like, oh, don't go too far away from the ship, or you'll, you know, get lost in space forever. Feels pretty viable. But nope, we had to go with the good old-fashioned invisible wall.
Explosives are set.
Good work, Kamina. Now let the whole station see what happens to traitors who sell out the OPA to the Inyas.
Is Drummer
I'm in.
Villain? Starting to wonder.
Another blast door.
Pshing. Fine, I'll get more explosives.
No need. I should be able to access the lockdown controls from the bridge.
Good thinking, Cap. Could still find more explosives. Just in case.
Yeah, obviously we're gonna do that. Since we have a whole fucking battalion of pirates looking for us, apparently.
Wouldn't let anyone get their hands on that tech. Good for them. They were heading toward Titania to link up with the Belta sect there. Almost made it.
Titania. Oh, what a fucking... What a controversy that is. Pronunciation of that name.
Looks like the crew tried to record a message.
This message is to all Erda and Martian security forces in the area. We have received your warnings and demands, and this will be our only response. The MCRN says we have stolen their property. The UNN says we are traveling illegally in their sector. We recognize neither of your claims over us. This is our belt.
Torpedoes, away! Incoming!
Stand down now and let us keep our course. We will either join our OPA Baratnas on Titania or sacrifice ourselves to your destruction. There is no other option. Beltalada! Who here is prepared to die for your belt?
Beltalada! 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 Beltalada!
You hear that?
Wouldn't surrender the tech. and sent their message in the only way the Inners understand.
What was the message?
That the Inners are the real thieves here. They take from us every day, and they'll keep doing it if we keep letting them.
Brave, Koyos.
Okay. Yeah, man, up and around. Just passed something that said Med Bay.
Yalik Pashang! If there's one thing all belters can agree on, is that the moldy filters kick ass.
Please tell me you're still alive.
Okay. Con and I had to trade a few punches, but we got her calm enough to attach the prosthetic. Aw, were you worried about me?
Of course I was. The next time you go up against Con, at least bring a torpedo.
Hey, I did okay without the heavy weaponry. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to find an ice pack.
That went surprisingly well.
I don't know what Kamina's standard is for surprisingly well, but that seems like it didn't. I don't know. Nothing in that med bay. Let's head over to mess hall.
After I wiped the floor with Dawes one time, he declared that Gogo was frivolous and banned OPA from playing. Typical.
Okay. Okay, there's reaction mass.
The static cube hacker might be useful.
Sure, might let you break into Rayon's special data drives.
Set up push toe!
We get all kinds of loot here. Oh, I have to.
Found another barrel.
Woo! This is loaded! Or whatever the Inyas say.
Don't like that the music stopped.
Touchdown! Woo!
I've got some radiation from a nearby ship, the Manitoba. Scanner shows the engine is mostly intact. Maybe a few pellets too.
Boss man, that's the far edge of the debris field. You'll be exposed.
You two head back to the Artemis. Everyone stays on the ship, but be ready to pick me up on my order.
This doesn't seem like it's a good idea. Then again, nothing I've done seems like it's been a good idea, so what the fuck? Sure. What's one more thing at this point? She's exposed.
Captain, we're picking up a communication from the Europa's Bane.
Sabaka, they locked us?
No, it's a broadcast. But they must know we're close.
Patch it over.
There is no sense in running anymore. You know who I am, and I am looking forward to meeting you. Contact me to discuss the terms of your surrender. Or... just sit and wait until we find you. It's only a matter of time.
Shit. Cap, you got to get back here.
Not without fuel pellets.
Stupid drone is stuck.
Okay.
Sabaka. I doubt they will all be so easy to kill.
Virgil, if I respond, will they be able to trace the signal?
No, it will only confirm you are in broadcast range. But they seem pretty sure of that already.
Put me through. Captain Zapata, this is Kamina Drummer of the Artemis. I don't want to fight you, but keep sending your crew after me, and I'll be forced to keep killing them.
Okay. Y'all know what my fucking favorite thing in video games is? Fucking forced stealth sections. Oh God!
A long way from Siri Station, Kamina Drummer.
You've heard of me?
I've heard of your work and your bounty. But if I'm speaking to you, what happened to Garrison Cox?
He attempted to double his profits. As a result, I am now captain.
Not surprising. There's no loyalty among scavengers. Not that the OPA is any better. You must really enjoy the company of miscreants.
I mean, I do, but... it's fucking rude to say. Nothing. I thought it was something. off!
She's over here!
Fastest gun in the fucking solar system, baby.
This one looks like an inner. Guess Toussaint and I have one thing in common. Keeping a crew of belters and inners from killing each other.
It was also a really unnecessary jump scare. Really fucking annoying for no reason. Okay, great. This is nothing. This is fully nothing. Just an empty room. There's nothing in it. Love that.
You can always retreat, Toussaint. Protect the rest of your crew.
Your reputation is well earned, Captain Drummer. Daniel and Yuri were two of my best. But their needless deaths do not change.
Enough. I've had a very long week in a crash couch because of you. Either fall back or keep sending your men to die. Those are your options.
Mars was running an analysis on the solenoid technology that the Belters stole. Why would they be attempting to reverse engineer their own design? Maybe the Belters on board the Leguane, they weren't thieves. Maybe they were engineers, contractors who created a technology that they knew they would never profit from and the Belt could never afford. They tried to share their work with people who needed it most and they were killed for it. Yeah, probably. That does seem like some shit that would happen. Right. There. All right. Easy peasy. Fuel. Bobby B. One box. One box of fuel pellets. Oh, shit. You fucked up. You fucked up. Oh, we're committing, huh? We're just... All right.
Please tell me this thing has ammo.
I'm on my way.
No! Everyone, stay back!
Why did she hold her arm up?
What's happening? Why are the pirates pulling away?
There are always more options, Captain. I'll have the coordinates. Even if I have to comb through rubble to find them. Goodbye.
You're bluffing. Hello? Toussaint! Come on. Gotta be some ammo left.
Does there have to be some ammo?
PDC delivery.
Sabaka! Are you crazy? You could get killed!
So could you! Now step back and let me do my job!
I thought you were-
I don't know what the fuck you two are doing, but I'm approaching your location on control thrusters for whenever we shut off.
Glad you're back at your post.
Yeah, she's got a cool robot arm now. Alright, let's fucking rock and roll, buckaroo!
What are you waiting for?!
We only get one shot before they know our position.
There! Oh boy. Okay. All right, easy. easy. Great. Okay. Oh, knock him out. That's all it took? Focus up, ladies. Come on. They still have missile launchers.
No!
It's truly not a good time. Okay, we're just gonna... Okay, no, great. Guess we probably were out of ammo. Oh. It's like, oh yay, we crippled their ship. They still have fucking missile launchers. They're actively trying to murder us.
Con! Now!
This is
crazy.
Are
they shooting? Are we locked? Con!
Luckily for you, I like crazy.
We're out of range now. Whatever the fuck you did, it worked.
Sorry, paint me like one of your French girls.
Well, I believe celebrations are in order.
That's it, huh? We did it? We won?
Coordinates are set for the MK core. Time to see what all the fucking fuss is about. With the fuel you found, we should have no problem getting there and back to Ganymede at least.
And how is the new prosthetic?
It'll do. Get some rest, Captain. No telling what we'll find at those coordinates.
I love that Khan just fully is asleep. Just fully fucking zonked out in the chair.
Hey, Khan.
Resting. Go away.
Can you believe how vicious these pirates are?
Yes.
I mean, how they were willing to blow us up just to prove a point.
Yes.
So you don't think there's anything special about them?
Yes, I do. They seem to have more guns.
Any guesses on our destination?
Nada. All I know is that it's far the fuck out there. So whoever hid that treasure, wanted it far the fuck away.
Good talking to you, Khan.
Yeah, yeah.
This game feels more and more like Treasure Planet the further we get into it. Not exactly, obviously, but like, broadly speaking. Well, I'm glad we didn't get the medicine for that one guy, and we did get the mushroom powder for the doctor.
It's been a rough week. I should check in with the crew and see how everyone's doing.
That's the plan. Oh, this is Cox's room. new Artemis log. So Khan, not Cox, is the owner of the Artemis. No wonder the records are spotty. Khan loves flying, which he doesn't like. Just it seems she has the patience for paperwork.
What are these? Decryption keys? Pushing voila! I knew Cox was paranoid, but spying on his crew?
I think I picked up a data cube. Like cracker or something.
I don't see myself drinking a dead man's scotch anytime soon. Maybe if things get desperate. Phew, Volota. Cox was even more unhinged than I imagined.
Wow, let me read this whole thing, because this looks like a fucking nightmare. You are the captain of the Artemis in rank and in title, and this bestows upon you tremendous and fearsome power. You're the arbiter of justice, of wealth, of accolades, and personal commendations, treasured by your crew. You are not a baby-dicked kibblehead. Khan has never seen you naked and therefore cannot judge your manhood, which is, in fact, adequate. Your crew respects and fears you, even Drummer. Khan's insults are a sign of respect. Arlen and Raylan are not plotting to overthrow you. The Martian is sexually attracted to you, and you have chosen not to pursue her due to your sense of discipline, which is soon to be rewarded with tremendous wealth. You will have tremendous wealth. All who doubted you will cry. Your drinking is not a problem. Ugh. All right. Maybe we did make the right call there. Cox was fucking... I absolutely fucking losing it. Maybe that was the right call.
Say what you will about Virgil, but he takes his job as ship's medic very seriously.
Oh, notes. Deceased.
The one thing I know about Virgil is that he's an excellent doctor. The rest is a mystery. At least we've only had one limb replacement so far. You're welcome, Rayan. Cox said Virgil was hiding something. Let's find out. Looks like Virgil has some anxiety from his past. Glad to see he is managing it.
I mean, who fucking doesn't?
For an Inna, he does make an excellent red kibble. Virgil grew up on Luna, but he's not like some Innas. He actually thinks of Beltas as people.
Not like a huge compliment, but...
Encrypted. But I picked up a data cube hacker in that ship graveyard. Should tell me what Virgil is hiding.
Hack data cube.
Hopefully this data hacker I found still works.
It'd be really embarrassing if it didn't.
Bingo. Apparently there's a lot Virgil hasn't shared about his past. Like his time as a UNN soldier.
Thank you for that hydrate, Shay. Here's your new identity, government ID, passport, birth certificate, UN ID card, while docking. Wow. So
Virgil's not even Virgil. Whatever he's hiding, it was enough to make him change his entire identity.
Thorsten, it's official. I'm attaching a copy of the warrant. If you haven't responded to my last three messages, I assume you're no longer interested in retaining my services. I stand by what I said before. You are under an incredible strain, which the court would likely take into account, but I can't defend you. Whew. Against desertion charge if you're still on the run. I can only advise, again, that you return to Lure. You're a brilliant surgeon, and this is will not define your career. Please think about your future and get in touch.
Ooh.
Not only did Virgil hide his UNN service and his real name, he's also wanted by his own government for desertion. I should try to get more information from him.
I mean, who isn't... Who isn't... You know, a little got some skeletons in the closet, so to speak. I mean, I'm not wanted for desertion, but like, you know. Still.
True belters take water, air, and sleep wherever they can find them. Say anything else about these two, but they are true belters.
This looks uncomfortable.
Maya and Virgil learned a lot of Lang Belter swear words in the past week. Khan seems to already know them all.
What's up, Virgil?
What's on your mind, Captain?
I found some mushroom powder for you to cook with.
Bursting with umami.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Exceptional. Thank you, Captain.
You're welcome.
You served in the UNN.
As a medic, yes. It was the only way I could afford medical school on Luna.
Hmm. Why did you desert?
Because I was finding it harder and harder to live with myself. Being stationed in the belt, I was surrounded by people in desperate need of my help. But because of the badge on my chest and the gun on my back, I was their enemy. One day, it became too much to bear.
Did you do something?
No, I never hurt anyone. I never raised my gun, not once. But what I saw taught me that there were two sides, and I was on the wrong one. I'm sorry, Captain. I hope that my actions on this ship can offer some amends for my past.
Why should I trust you?
Because I sacrificed everything I have to get away from my past and start a new life here in the belt.
I understand, but if there's anything else I need to know, I expect you to tell me.
Of course.
Thank you.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Captain, is my UNN past going to be a problem for us?
You were stationed in the belt. That means you were occupying my home.
I know.
The way I see it, you're wanted by the UNN for desertion. I'm wanted for fighting them. Sounds like we're both on the same side.
Thank you, Captain.
Okay, Bane's gone to bed, so I don't have to pick all the evil dialogue options. How am I going? Look around here and any goodies. I think that's really what this game is. It's how much looking around and skulking about can you do where you get bored?
Honestly, I'm glad Maya finally got one. This was starting to get sad.
What are you listening to?
It's Martian music. You wouldn't like it.
I'll decide what I like and don't like.
Can't wait to play this game again and hear what the actual music is instead of the copyright-free substitute.
There's a letter I keep that was sent from the front. I don't know if you're hurt or worse, but my heart hangs on these words you wrote. My dear love, I miss you more than these words could ever say. Though this war may take my body, my heart is yours. We will meet again. Go and see how the wind meets the hills. Hear my voice in each whisper. Look for me.
The whole sequence, huh?
And I'll be with you in starlight. My dear love, I miss you more than these words could ever say. Oh, this. chance. I never kiss your lips, never see you smile, never hear your voice, never touch your face again. My dear love, I miss you more than these words could ever say.
I guess this has been going on for too long.
Well,
it just goes on forever. Great. I assumed it would stop at some point. Joke's on me.
My mom used to play it for us on the guitar. Half the time she'd break down crying and not even finish it. It reminded her of my dad. It's funny. I hate my dad. I hate the army he died for. And I hate Mars. But I still miss it.
What you did in the debris field was incredibly reckless. You disobeyed my order, and you put the whole—
Oh my god. You're fucking welcome.
I was getting to that. Thank you.
Anytime.
Khan seemed pleased with her prosthetic.
That's good. Although you realize we just took the most unhinged person on the ship and gave her a bionic skull crusher for an arm.
Yeah,
I think if Khan wanted to kill someone, she could do it without arms or legs. I'll leave you to it then.
Wait. About that moment in the airlock.
Yes?
Are you feeling any better? I know you were pretty scared, given how tightly you were holding my hand.
I'm pretty sure you grabbed my hand in there.
Oh, sure. We can go with that if you want. I'm just saying, I'm here if you need to talk.
The only thing we need to talk about is your delusion of fantasizing about me.
I get it. It must be hard for the boss Meng to express her feelings. Especially to the hot Martian engineer who can totally kick your ass.
Not according to that scoreboard.
My point is, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Even if you did clink helmets with me.
Clink helmets? What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. Helmet clinker.
Let's pretend for a moment that we did touch helmets. So what? You're clearly obsessing over such an insignificant moment. It's sad.
Bullshit. From the look in your eyes, I would have thought helmet clinking was belt or third base. You know, we could stand here talking about hands and helmets all night. Or we could go back to my room and settle it.
Jesus Christ!
By settle it, are you talking about sex?
Yeah, you idiot.
Only one way to find out.
Get some well-deserved rest. Oh, hey, look, comlogs.
If I sleep with Maya, the entire crew will know about it. Nothing stays secret on a ship like this. Is one night worth all the drama?
I just want to see what happens. I just want to see what happens. Sorry, I love how dramatic the music is. Bum bum! Like, this is on the same level as shunting a man out of an airlock.
Definitely.
Fucking finally. When Cox sat us down in the mess hall, I thought you were dead. And today in the airlock, I thought we were dead.
I know.
I'm just saying, you're not allowed to die on me, Kamina Drimmer. Because I'm not losing the one person in the belt I give a shit about.
That was a very abrupt end to that music and leading into the loading screen. Oh, good! Con, wake up. Something bad's coming.
What the hell?
Captain, you're gonna want to see this.
There's nothing on the map. No record of any settlements. So what the fuck is that?
The MK Corps is what I'm assuming.
We did it!
Alright. I think we're gonna cut it here. I think we're gonna do a little bit of Remnant 2 now, just to kind of go just a little bit longer here. But okay. Khan's surgery. 43% found the laser crystal for Khan's surgery. Virgil trust. Drummer told Arlen and Raylan that she trusts Virgil. 18% not sure. 22% drummer in Arlen and Raylan never discussed Virgil. Good. 54% drummer heard the whole story of Khan's surgery from Maya. Interesting. Um, 64% didn't find the medication. 36% gave Arlen medication. And 0% found the medication but didn't give it to Arlen. Could you imagine just fully being like, yeah, no, fuck you. 22% didn't find it. Again, found it and just didn't give it to him. 50% of people didn't discover anything about Virgil's past. Wow. 2% didn't talk to Virgil about his past. Interesting. Scotch for Cox. 22% Cox wasn't in the brig. 26% drummer didn't bring Cox anything. Drummer gave Cox his bottle of scotch. Wild. 86% of people spent the night with Maya, obviously. Obviously. Mausoleum mining station.
If you are receiving this message, it means you've found us at last. You've come, and with you comes the next great step in the evolution of humanity.
We have been preparing for your arrival for years, perhaps centuries. We have been patient. We know you have much to teach us. If you can hear my voice, whoever you are, welcome home.
It just repeats after that.
Who was that?
The head of the station, presumably.
Sounds more like a cult leader to me. Someone who flew too far from home. Generations ago, millions of Earthers tried to set up mining stations in the belt. Some of them lasted. Some died off right away. And some of them, no one knows.
Still, a station this large, uncharted, and seemingly uninhabited? It's like nothing I've heard of.
What did the initial scans tell us?
None of the scanners penetrate past the first level. but there are no heat signatures, no activity except this broadcast. Looks clear.
Maybe. But we don't know who stashed it here. Or who else they might have told about it.
Not to mention, how the fuck are we gonna find it in there? The place is massive.
There was a line in the coordinates. Something about the first ones.
Fuck does that mean?
Won't know till we get inside. Arlen, Rayan, stay on the ship. Be ready to burn hard if there's any activity on the radar.
Sure thing, boss man. Good hunting.
Maya and I will head inside and search around.
Wow, they knew immediately. They knew immediately. There wasn't even like a single bit of like, oh, well, maybe, maybe not. Nope. Bow. Oh. Wild. Sorry, we are gonna cut it here. It's just there's cutscenes. I can't cut it yet.
Exactly how old is this place?
Too old to be on any maps. Maybe 100 years?
Damn.
I agree.
This is fucking strange.
Let's search for the command center.
Found it. Over here.
Maya, why are you fucking walking away again? We just went through... You just found, like, a whole ass battalion of heads an hour ago. Guess it was, like, 2 weeks ago in-game, but...